Hi friends, Chandrasekhar here again, and now we are into the 26th of the series of lectures on my concept about Jaimini Sutra, and I'll wind it up at the end of all the lectures. Was there over those I am going to talk about? And as we have seen, we are going about the Upapada and the Upapada Lagna, and of course then the second form. We started with Tatra Papasya Papa Yoga Pravajja Dara Nashova. Meaning, if the second from the Upapada Lagna is occupied by a malefic or aspected by a malefic, then the Jataka suffers loss of spouse or becomes an ascetic. Again, which means he doesn't have any spouse. So, loss is, we can say, it's a term which is applicable to both the states. Either you don't have a spouse or you lose the spouse that you have. And the sutra, as you know, is a thread. So we are continuing with the same thing. And now the ninth sutra in the first chapter, fourth pada, the fourth quarter, goes Ucche tasmin uttama kulat dar labhaha. So, Ucche means in exaltation. You can also take it as in the Katapayadi manner of looking at it, in which case it might perhaps go to the sixth, and so U will naturally become zero, and so you can say the 12th, but it doesn't appear to be from 12. It is talking about, because this is a sutra, so why should it suddenly shift to something else? He could have used other word instead of Ucche. So if planet in exaltation is placed in the second from the Upapada Lagna, some also think that it could also mean the Upapada Lagna itself. I tend to differ, but it is an opinion of the learner, and you can accept whatever is acceptable to you. And what happens then, the Dara, that is the spouse, is from a exalted clan, so her family might be either well placed or very renowned. Because in ancient day, it was more than the wealth, it was the reputation of the family which was more supposed to be more important, or the intellect for which the family was known was supposed to be uttam. So, if the planet placed in is in exaltation, then the spouse will be from a good family, is what he said. Then the next one comes Niche Viparyaya. Viparyaya means opposite. So if it is in debility, then this would mean exactly opposite of that. Niche can also be decoded as 12th from the Upapada Lagna, but I don't think that is the meaning of it. I still think we are continuing with the thread of second from the Upapada Lagna, which, as I explained, I think, if I remember right, when I explained all the formats of Upapada, perhaps the 12th from the Lagna is to be taken as Upapada, and then its pada, that is the Upapada Lagna, is to be seen, and then see what is happening on the second format. Then he says, Shubha Sambandhat Sundari. So, what is this? Yeah, naturally, if it is Uccha, or even if it is Niche, planet placed in the sacred, if there is benefic aspect, Sambandha means different type of Sambandha, including placement, aspects, even perhaps exchange of houses between the lords of those places, would all come under the Shubha Sambandha. So if benefics are there influencing that, as I said, always aspect or occupation, I would more look at it as influencing that bhava, then, because planets do not have eyes, as we know. And it is made even more clear when they say that sun represents right eye, moon represents left eye, and Venus rules over eyesight, not eyes. So at least barring the sun and moon, perhaps nobody has eyes. And that was what was to be conveyed to us, and by extension, of course, they also don't have it. They have influence. So, Shubha Sambandha Sundari, then the spouse will be beautiful or handsome, depending on the sex of the spouse. I need not repeat here again. I have repeated it many a time that in astrology it is generally sex neutral. So when we say spouse, when we say patni, it would also mean pati if the jataka is a female. Of course, in modern days it can mean anything with the LGBT community, but see, somebody with whom you interact regularly, with whom you intend to stay for life, long life, throughout your life, hopefully at the beginning of the that bond occurring, which we call marriage, is how I would look at it. Then he goes, okay, this is over. What happens when Uccha is there? What happens when Papa is there? The Maleficent. This is about single planet, obviously. Remember that this would not apply necessarily if there are multiple planets, and that is explained now in the, I think, the 12th Sutra. When he says, Rahu Shani Bhyam Apavadat Tyago Nashova. If Rahu and Saturn occupy Tatra, occupying the second bhava from the Upapada Lagna, then either one will give up the relationship, the spouse, because of some, what can I say, loss of reputation of the spouse. Apavada is loss of reputation, you can say, or some, because of some sort of, you know, maybe infidelity. Apavada is anything which brings a blemish to you. Where will the blemish be there? Because we are talking about marriage and lasting of marriage or the spouse. So obviously the matter is marital. Or the jataka might lose the spouse. Nasho va means or. So apavada tyago, you give up the relationship, or the person with whom you are forming a relation is destroyed. Destroyed means dies. I would say the marriage breaks. I mean, not those many number of people die, so obviously it is breakage of the bond. The nash of the bond of the marriage is what is being indicated here. This is my opinion. Literally, it would be nash means the death of the spouse. Then, what is it? Shukra Ketu Bhyam. If Shukra, that is Venus and Ketu, are placed in the second bhava from the Upapada Lagna, not the Upapada, please remember, then whatever, Rakta Pradara, there will be problem of the menstrual cycle of the spouse. What happens in case of the male? He would not have. So my understanding is, in that case there would be some problem is his semen, either the quantity or the quality, or not being the with the same potency all the while. That is what would happen, is how I would look at it. Here it is said, Shukra Ketu Bhyam Rakta Pradara. Rakta Pradara is a disease of the menstrual cycle and the reproductive for a female. But the Shastra being, you have to apply your right, and ultimately Shukra indicates the semen and the virya, the ability to procreate. So in a male, obviously it would be connected with the semen or the sperm rather than the menstrual cycle as such. So Rakta Pradara is excessive flow or scanty flow of the when menses occur, there is scanty flow. That is what is told here. Next is said, Shani Ravi Rahu Bir. V is used when more than two things come together in Sanskrit. So Shani Rahi, Shani Ravi Rahu Bir Astichwara. Astichwara is a low type of disease, low lying disease. Could be called disease of the bones. It could also be, see, Ravi is there, so you know, Ravi rules over, Ravi, that means sun rules over bones. Rahu is something which is unknown. Saturn gives something for a long duration. It could also be rheumatoid arthritis sort of thing, where the inflammation happens and arthritis is there. That is also a disease of bones primarily and joints. This is how I would look at it. You decide. Then comes Buddha Ketu Astisravo Buddha Ketu Bhyam. If Mercury and Ketu are together, where of course in the second from the Upapada Lagna, then there would be Astisrava. Astisrava and Astijvara, what is the difference? Strava is generally what we call some sort of a flow, gradual flow. So this could mean the osteosporosis, possibly. Again here, Buddha is there, so this is a Tridosha Yukta, so you just can't wish it away, it will always remain. I think we have talked about it in diseases, a lecture on diseases. If I have not, I will give it later on, a special sort of lecture on only how I look at diseases. So, Buddha is Tridosha Yukta, so whatever he has will remain forever. Ketu gives up. And second from Upapada Lagna, he perhaps tends to do that. I would have thought it would be more the Astisrava will be connected with Ravi and Ketu, because Ravi rules over bones. So it could be that the sutra is wrong, or the sage says that this is something which will last throughout his body, throughout the Jataka's life, rather Jataka's spouse's life. Of course, this has nothing to do with Jataka, as we know. We are talking about the Upapada Lagna and second from it. So, spouse of the Jataka would have something continuously, which could be certainly the osteoporosis. And Ketu, the giver up, perhaps gives it up all the while. Not sometimes. Like Astijvara would be, sometimes you will have, as we have seen in the earlier sutra, Astijvara, because of Shani, Ravi and Rahu, Saturn, Sun and Rahu, that would come intermittently. Some people have a low level of fever which suddenly erupts, suddenly goes down. And here, it will be giving up, perhaps continuously, and so Ketu is there, and so Astisrava Buddha Ketu Bhya might be the right one, because so many commentators have never thought of it being connected with Ravi. But I am giving my point of view, it could also be only Ravi with Ketu, because here they are not talking, I mean the sage is not talking about the Rahu. And earlier, Buddha Ketu, then you will see the next one, when we go to the third one, you will see that it is talking about something else. And what happens is, I have told you the other way around, first comes the Astisrava Buddha Ketu Bhyam, and then comes the Ravi Ravi, Shani Ravi Rahu, Bhir Astijvara. Now the next which comes is 16th, I suppose. Yeah, I think it is 16th of the sutra, which says Buddha Ketu Bhyam Stavlam. Now Stavlam is being obese. Now, why obese? The same combination in the second house will give obesity, and osteoporosis is something which I find a bit difficult to understand. Though I am nobody to question what the sutra says. It says Buddha Ketu Bhyam Stavlyam, that the spouse will be bulky. And this actually is the reason why I think that the 14th sutra perhaps Astisrava Buddha Ketu Bhyam could be perhaps Ravi Ketu Bhyam. Because after that comes the Shani Ravi Rahu Sthira Jvara. So maybe Ravi Ravi, I mean sutra, because it is in order, that is what I was thinking about. Just think about it yourselves, apply it to the charts that you get and find out and let me know what is the result. As I said, at my age, I don't find time enough, because too many people come and ask about their problems. And I also teach those who are already highly educated in the field of astrology. I mean, I don't teach in the traditional system, I only discuss the principles. So I find it difficult to make time for this also. After finish off my work at my small shop, which is my source of livelihood, then I record the video. That is why every time I talk about good night, I never say good day or good morning or when I close the lecture. Then what happens? Then something else is coming up. No, here it is said, Buddha Kshetri, in the house of Buddha. That means the second from the Upapada Lagna, should it happen to be the house, that is Rashi of Buddha, Mercury, that is, should it be either Gemini or the Virgo Rashi? And should there be Mandara Abhyam? Manda means Shani, Saturn. Ara means Mars. So if both are there, then Nasika Rogaha. So we are now approaching almost the end of the this lecture. Perhaps I will be able to keep it really within my limit of 20 minutes. Because then later on, there are many other diseases also being told, and I might overrun the time, which I generally do not like anyway. So, as we have seen, Buddha Kshetre Mandara Abhyam Nasika Rogah, which means in the house of Buddha, which means of course the Rashi of Buddha, Kshetra, Bhava, Rashi, Bhava are all synonyms, is what the great Kalyan Varma has already said. So we need not be confused about it. So Buddha Kshetre Mandara Abhyam Nasika Rogah. Nasika is nose. Second from the Upapada Lagna is where this has to happen. Then what happens is the person will have disease of nose. Now you know the second bhava is the face, and this Upapada Lagna and its second. Obviously, since the Upapada Lagna is the spouse herself or himself, obviously, and the second from it is the dhana of the spouse, so the longevity of the marital bond, perhaps that is how the sage is talking about the second from the Upapada Lagna and not the Upapada Lagna itself, as we would normally do. But we have seen, because Upapada itself, second from Upapada can give harm to the marital part, being the 12th from the Lagna, so it would be aspecting the 7th, or that is why then when Upapada Lagna is there, again second from it is taken. So that is pretty clear, isn't it? And what happens is, Nasika is nose. If it happens to be the Rashi owned by Mercury, which is Gemini and Virgo, then in that case, there will be some disease to the nose of the spouse, is what is being told by the sage. Why perhaps is that if we look at everything, then this second bhava from Upapada Lagna would be indicating of the, in a way, as good as the second from the Lagna itself, and so it's a complex concept. So maybe I am not explaining it properly, but it would represent perhaps the nose of the spouse, and Buddha himself being with Tridosha, as we have seen in the earlier shloka, as I have said in the earlier sutras, and then Manda, the slow one, the gradual erosion, and Ara causing some harm, some cut, some damage to the nose, is perhaps indicated. He goes one step ahead, and in the next sutra says, Kuja Kshetre Cha. Same thing will happen if that happens to be the bhava or the rashi of owned by Kuja. Kuja means again Mars. Ara, Kuja, Vakra, all are actually the names, various names of Mars, even Bhauma, the son of Bhumi, is all meaning Mars. Mangal, of course, is Mars. Same thing. And Cha means also. So same thing will happen if Saturn and Rahu are placed in the second from Upapada, which happens to be the Rashi owned by the great Mars. Then also that person's spouse will have disease of the nose. I think I'll close here because next sutra will talk about something which is a bit unclear to me also, but I have seen something in Ayurveda and tried to find out what it is, and it would take some time. So I will not waste your time. I will say good night to you. I hope you like this lecture. You might think that I am giving it in a hurry. I am, because there are too many sutras and I want to keep my self-imposed time limit of 20 minutes. So, my dear friends, I take your leave.